Welcome. In this video, we're going to go over the midpoint rule and then use an example where we apply the midpoint rule. So every Riemann sum is an approximation of an integral. However, if we choose midpoints, we can rewrite the definition of the definite integral. And I'm going to cross this out since I don't remember what page it is from the current notes that you're using. So we can write it out as follows, and that's the integral from a to b of f of x dx is approximately the sum of the rectangles where this is f evaluated at the midpoint and delta x is the width of each rectangle. And that's equal to delta x times f of x1 bar plus f of x2 bar plus all the way to f of x sub n bar. And now what are all these symbols here, right? What are all these x bar, delta x? Well, like in previous videos, we said delta x is b minus a over n. So this is the width of the rectangles. And remember, we have n rectangles. And on our interval, a is the lowest x value, b is the max value, and n is the number of rectangles. Xi bar is 1 half times xi minus 1 comma xi, and again this is from a previous video where each interval starts from a smaller number, so we could go x0 to x1 would be one interval, x1 to x2 would be another interval. So as you can see, this is the right end of the interval and this is the left end, and in general that xi bar is the midpoint of the interval. Now let's look at an example. Use the midpoint rule with n equals 5 to approximate the integral of 1 over x from 1 to 2. So let's start with delta x. So what is delta x? Well, delta x equals b minus a over n. So that's 2 minus 1 over 5. So again, we have our max, our min, and we have 5 rectangles, so we're approximating it that way. So this ends up with being 1 over 5, which is 0.2. So next, what are the midpoints? So what are the values of xi bar, i.e. the midpoints of each interval? Okay, so for that, let's draw a sketch. That should help this be a little bit easier. So we're going to start at 1, and then we're going to go all the way here to 2, since we're going from 1 to 2. And remember, we said that our delta x is 0.2, so that's 1/5. So let's break this up. So I'm going to go 1.2, 1.4, 1.6, 1.8, and let me label these now. And now we can figure out what these i's are. This is x1 bar, that's the first interval. This is x2 bar, since this is the second interval. So that's a 1. This is the second interval. That's where this 2 comes from. This is x3 bar, since this is the third interval. And I'm going to stop color coding these now because I think everyone is, at least at this point, following along with what's going on here. So this is x4 bar and this is x5 bar. So we have to figure out what each midpoint is. So x1 bar is equal to 1 half times 1.2 plus 1. So that's 2.2 divided by 2, which is just 1.1. And so this is the midpoint right here, is 1.1. Pause your video now and see if you can determine what these midpoints are. So this is 1.3, 1.5, 1.7, 1.9. So those are all your midpoints. And now's a good time to erase all this extra junk here we don't need anymore. All right, so now let's compute our integral. So, compute integral. We have the integral from 1 to 2 of 1 over x dx is equal to delta x times f of x1 bar plus f of x2 bar plus f of x3 bar plus f of x4 bar plus f of x5 bar. So this is 0.2 times f of 1.1 plus f of 1.3 plus f of 1.5. If you notice, I'm just taking these values that I found for the midpoints and plugging them in. So x2 is equal to 1.3, so that goes in here. And so go ahead and do that for all of these. All right, so now let's evaluate. And remember, f of x is right here. F of x equals 1 over x. So all of these just become 0.2 times 1 over 1.1 plus 1 over 1.3, and so on. And actually, before I continue, let me fix this. This is not exact here. This is an approximation. So from this step here to this step, we're approximating the area under this curve. We end up with about 0.6919. And if you want to see how close you are, let's open up GeoGebra. So let's type in y equals 1 divided by x. And then we're going to type in the word integral. And then, of course, parentheses. And we're going f. Oops, that's a prime, comma. And we went from 1 to 2 and hit enter. And if you notice, that gives you about 0.69, which is fairly accurate. Let's see if I can change the decimal places. Oops, that's not what I wanted. I wanted, say, 10 decimal places. 0.693147108 06, which is fairly close. So we are accurate to 2 decimal places, but no longer to 3 decimal places with our approximation. So our approximation using Riemann sums with n equals to 5 rectangles and the midpoint rule was pretty good. Hope this video helps.